Now it's time for the hot knife versus the liquid metal. Let's try this.
Whoa! It's crazy!
What's up, it's Collins Key, and today I'm doing another experiment. This is kind of like a DIY. I'm gonna be playing with gallium, which is basically liquid metal. Like if you hold it in your hands, it's liquid. We're gonna be doing a whole bunch of crazy experiments with it, and I've heard if you put just a small little drop on the top of a Coca-Cola can, it'll actually destroy it. So make sure you guys stick around till the very end to watch that, and also, if you wanna learn how to bend a spoon, where'd it go? With your mind, all you have to do is just go to my Instagram right now and I will teach you how to do it. Your own magic trick you can freak your friends out with. So if you want to learn that, the direct link is down in the description to my Instagram. And if you like that video and comment on it, Keeper Squad, I'll be going through, liking your photos, DMing you guys. And right now, I have a challenge for you. Before we get into this, I want to see if you can subscribe to this channel and turn on the channel post notifications in 5 seconds. Here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, done. If you can do that, why do I still have a spoon? Comment down below, Spoon Squad, because why not? Actually, don't. We'll stick to Keeper Squad. Just comment that down below if you could do that. And right now, let's get into this video. It's time to crack these open and start playing with it. But first, as you guys know, for me, safety is the number one priority, so. So I put the gallium in some warm water over here because it turns into liquid at room temperature right now. So it was a little bit cold to begin with, but let's start playing with it. And you know what? I think these gloves are too much, so yeah. Actually, no, this jacket's too much. Yeah. So now it's time to play with the first little bit of gallium, and it's already like moving around on the inside, which is crazy. Like metal shouldn't do that. So here we go, we're gonna open this up. I don't think it's toxic, so hopefully I'll be good, but check this out. Oh my god, sorry. Look at that. Okay, so I'm gonna like hold it in my hand, just kinda like see what happens. That is insane. Look at it. Check this out. Okay, hold on. Oh, geez, it like spread out everywhere. Hold on. I'm gonna try to like dump it from hand to hand. This is so bizarre. This stuff is so cool. I want to see like what happens if you poke it. It like doesn't get on your finger at all. This stuff is the craziest feeling thing. And it's like warm too. Like it feels like unnaturally warm. All right, so now that we've got this, oh no, I tried. Oh! No! What do I do? My family's gonna be so mad. They love this table. Oh my, what do I do? How do I get it? Fam, I was not prepared. It's like hardening, fam. It's hardening on the glass. Oh my gosh, okay. What do,
In hindsight, I should have put this down first and that would have never happened. But hey, you live and you learn. And right now, about to play with this stuff again. Hopefully, we'll not spill it on the table. Keep it in this section. The first experiment we're kicking it off with is this Coca-Cola can, because if you put a drop of the gallium on top of it, it'll actually decompose the aluminum. So in about 30 minutes, I'll be able to tap it and it'll just completely fall apart. So I'm gonna do that right now. And then at the end of this video, it'll be ready to go. I can tap it and we'll see what happens, but we've gotta get it started right now. So let's do this.
Here we go. It's gonna put a teeny little drop. I guess we wait. For this one, we're playing with some frozen mold. So I've got some faces over here. We're gonna be ending it with a full on Olaf, like a full metal Olaf that might melt. That'd actually be really sad. Well, we're gonna start with the faces first. So I think we're gonna go, I like the reindeer looking dude. That is actually a reindeer, not a dude. The reindeer looking fella. And I know I will get absolutely roasted in the comments if I don't do Elsa in this. So I'll do the reindeer and Elsa. I made y'all happy. So we're gonna start off right here. I have one tube of gallium. This stuff looks pretty liquid at the moment. Here we go, about to dump it in 3, 2, 1, here we go. See, it almost comes out as like a tube, but I want like more liquid. Okay, I have an idea. Here we go, we got the blow dryer, let's turn it on. Let's see if this works, that'll be so cool. Yo, I can feel it literally melting under my finger right now. It's like actually melting it.
Fam, I'm a genius, y'all. I'm an absolute genius. I just had an even better idea.
So that still isn't going fast enough, so I'm gonna use my palm right now, which supposedly is gonna make it melt faster. I really have a hard time believing that that's gonna be what happens. We're gonna close it up like this and see if I can like turn it into liquid, and then I'll like squeeze it into this little mold here.
20 minutes later.
Yeah, I'm feeling nothing. It's still pretty solid. Back to the blow dryer.
Oh
The gallium has finally set, so now we're gonna go with the reindeer one first, then we'll pull out Elsa, so here we go.
Oh my gosh.
This actually worked.
Yo, check this out. This looks so cool.
So we got the first one, now it's time to get Elsa, and then I wanna try something really crazy. Yo, okay, this one turned out like even better. Right now I'm gonna take the blow dryer and see if I can actually melt these down and just see what happens. But I'm gonna do it in the palm of my hand. Oh, it's actually really hot on my hand. Like, it's really hot, but hold up, let me see. Ooh, it's hot. Well, the finger doesn't stick into it, but it does kind of, yo, it's melting like around my hand. So let me see if I close my hand, but it is turning into liquid though, because watch, I can kind of like drip it off. Look at, oh, dude. All right, so it started melting a little bit, so let's see if we can actually get it to like drip off.
That looks so crazy.
Here's the name of the game, get a little bit of gallium to roll into the mold. Let's see. Oh, it splashed. Uh-oh, okay, get it off, get it off, get it off. And now, and now, and now. That was very aggressive. I am so sorry, Olaf. We are gonna make the very first ever metal melting Olaf. So, let's do it.
Yo, come on, just a little bit more gallium. No, we have to get more gallium.
I'm actually really excited for this one. We have right here.
Yo, oh my gosh.
It turned out so good. This next part may be hard to watch. So for those of you guys who are squeamish, you might want to look away. We're gonna take Olaf and see if we can melt him.
All right, let's do this.
We're gonna go from the top down off of this operation. We're gonna go full blast. Maximum power. It's working, he's melting. It worked, we melted Olaf.
RIP.
For this one, we're using the gallium to duplicate a key. Now, not the Collins not this key, but an actual ordinary house key. So I've made this mold right here. It takes about 6 hours to make it. If you want to make it at home, all you have to do is just take a tube, put some clay on the bottom of it, and fill it with a lot of Jello, and then stick a key inside. I think you put it in your fridge for about like 6 hours, and then you have this mold just like this. So, ugh. All I have to do to remove it is using my thumb. I just have to take it, boom, and then it'll pop it out. So let's try this. A good fury smack. Yay! Yay, it worked! So now we've got it out. It's like super squishy because it's made out of Jello. We've got the key inside, and now it's time to finish up this thing. For this next part, you'll need an adult to help you out because you're gonna use an X-Acto knife to cut open the side of the gelatin that has a key in it, and then you're gonna remove the key that's in it at the moment. All right, so we cut it open, and you can actually see the mold of the key inside of it. So next step, we're gonna put it back together, put it back in the tube, and then pour in the gallium, and hopefully create a key mold.
Fam. This one might not have worked.
So now we have to leave this for 2 hours and then we're gonna see how it looks. So let's fast forward.
2 hours later.
This one's like a Jacob Sartorius song. It's either gonna be a hit or miss. Let's see, if this works, I'm going to be amazed right now. So we're gonna pop it open. It's not looking good at the moment, but here we go. Yeah, that actually, yo, straight up. That's actually not too shabby. You definitely could not use it as an actual key, but like it resembles a key more than I actually thought it would. Like it's crazy, you can see like the ridges, the lines, like this is an actual key. Again, I don't think it would work in a lock because I feel like the whole thing would just turn to liquid as you like stick it in to like, I don't know, get in your house, but I'm very surprised. If I hadn't added a whole bunch of extra stuff and just been extra, it would have worked out very well. And now the moment you've all been waiting for, time to test out to see if this gallium really was able to dissolve this Coca-Cola can. And make sure if you want to learn a magic trick, go check out my Instagram video right now. The direct link is down below. Like it, comment, keep it squad. I'll be DMing you guys, liking your photos. But right now, this is the one. Just gonna hit it like this. Whole thing should just like crumble. Maybe it explodes, maybe it implodes, maybe it creates a black hole. I don't know. Let's just do it. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. What? That literally didn't work. The gallium just popped right off. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? But yeah, the internet said this would work, and I always trust the internet, so I'm very disappointed right now. But you know what? No, I will not end the video this way. Right now, we're going for this. All right, guys, here we go. I left it overnight. That way, it has the most amount of time possible to hopefully disintegrate the can. So right now, the moment of truth. Let's do this. Here we go.